हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ शैलेंद्र सूर्यवंशी, वर्किंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री, केरी कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी, बेलगावी। गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट द फार्मास्यूटिकल एनालिसिस ऑफ सुक्रोज। द कंटेंट ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू सुक्रोज, केमिस्ट्री ऑफ सुक्रोज, फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सुक्रोज, यूजर्स ऑफ सुक्रोज एंड द फार्मास्यूटिकल एनालिसिस ऑफ सुक्रोज। कमिंग टू द इंट्रोडक्शन, द सुक्रोज इज अ कॉमन शुगर, इट इज अ डायसैकेराइड। Disaccharide means it is a unit, two units of the monosaccharide. And here our glucose, the sucrose contains the two units of monosaccharide, mainly the glucose and the fructose. The sucrose is mainly produced naturally in the plant, that is the cane sugar, from which the table sugar is refined. It has a molecular formula C12H22O11. Coming to the chemistry of sucrose, the chemical structure of sucrose is given here. And if you observe on the structure of the sucrose, it contains the two monosaccharides, mainly the glucose and fructose. It is a non-reducing sugar, has a chemical formula C12H22O11. Coming to the physical properties of the sucrose, sucrose is a monocyclic, monoclinic crystal structure. When it is subject to high temperature, over 186 degrees Celsius, the compound undergoes the decomposition to yield the caramel. It has a standard enthalpy of combustion which corresponds to the sucrose is 5647 kilojoule per mole. The solubility of this sucrose is very good in water, and at a temperature of 20 degrees Celsius, around 203.9 gram per ml sugar is going to be dissolved or solubilizes in the water. Coming to the chemical properties, sucrose can undergo a combustion reaction to give the carbon dioxide and water. When sucrose reacted with the chloric acid, it gives the hydrochloric acid, carbon dioxide and the water. The hydrolysis of the sucrose, it gives the two molecules of monosaccharide, mainly the one is glucose, another one is the fructose. The sucrose can be dehydrated with the help of H2SO4 as a catalyst to give rise to the black solid which is rich in the carbon. Coming to the therapeutic uses, or we can say the uses or the applications of the sucrose. Sucrose has a wide range of applications and users in the pharmaceutical as well as in the other chemical industries. One of the very most important use of the sucrose is it is used as a sweetening agent. It is also used in the used as a component of soft drinks and other beverages. Also, it is used mainly in the pharmaceutical preparations or the pharmaceutical products. It is an intermediate for many emulsifying agent and detergents. In the food, it is used as a food thickening agent and the food stabilizer. The shelf life of many products can be enhanced with the help of the sucrose, such as jams and jellies. And it has a good antioxidant activity, and also it is used as a food preservative. And already we have discussed one of the major uses, is used as a sweetening agent in the food as well as in the pharmaceutical products. Coming to the pharmaceutical analysis aspects of the sucrose. The analysis of sucrose is very much essential as it is consumed by the large number of populations worldwide. The proper analysis and quality control of the sucrose is very much essential. So, coming to the pharmaceutical analysis, the Indian Pharmacopoeia has given some tests to be performed and which has to be passed by the sucrose. So, there are some tests. So, I highlighted here, enlisted some analytical aspects of the sucrose. So, test to be performed for the quality control of the sucrose, which includes the description, solubility test, identification test, acidity and alkalinity, appearance of the solution, conductivity limit, followed by the specific optical rotation limit, test for barium and calcium, heavy metal limits, test for sulfites and dextrins, glucose and inverse sugar, coloring matter, loss on drying, lead limit and the sulfated ash limit. So these are some tests we have to be performed for the quality control analysis of the sucrose, and the specification are given as follows. So coming to the description test, it is one of the physical, the observational tests. So the sugar should be a dry, colorless crystal, and it is a crystalline powder. It should be odorless, and it should be have the sweet in taste. Coming to the solubility aspect, it should be very soluble or freely soluble in water, as well as it should be freely soluble in 70% ethanol. It should be sparingly soluble in ethanol. sometime. And coming to the identification test, it has to pass some three tests, mainly the color reaction, followed by the IR spectra of the sucrose should be matched with that of the standard spectra, the TLC. In the TLC, the principal spot in the chromatogram obtained with the test solution is similar in the position, the color and size of the principal spot in the chromatogram obtained with the reference solution. It means it should pass the TLC of the with reference to the standard. Followed by the acidity and alkalinity test, it should pass the test of for the acidity and the alkalinity. Followed by the solution should be clear and colorless with respect to the appearance and the solution test. Coming to the conductivity limit, it should not more than 35 microsecond per centimeter. The specific optical rotation measured for the sucrose should be between plus 65.9 degree and plus 67.0 degree. The test for barium and calcium, it should pass the test for barium and calcium within the acceptance limit, and it should not have more than 10 ppm heavy metals content in it. And also the sulfide and dextrin test should be passed with given specification in the pharmacopoeia, as well as the glucose and inverse sugar. The weight of the cuprous oxide is more than 1112 mg obtained in the test and should pass the as per the specification. The coloring matter, any fluorescence is not more than more intense than that of the solution containing 0.4 mg of quinine sulfate in 0.05 molar sulfuric acid. So coloring matter should, test should be passed for the quality control analysis of the sucrose. The loss on drying limit should be not more than 0.1%. The lead limit should not be not more than 0.5 ppm. And sulfated ash limit should not exceed 0.1%. So these are some pharmaceutical analysis and aspects in the quality control of the sucrose. These are the references. Thank you one and all.